This tutorial is part of our Building a Python Package course, where we learn how to build, test, and automate deployment of a Python Django middleware package to the Python package index. You can watch the entire course uninterrupted, ad-free, and access updated tutorial source code and other resources from our Udemy course. Now, alternatively, you can access the course via our YouTube playlist. This features tutorials from the course. Links to the YouTube course and YouTube playlist can be found in the video description. So now we are ready to develop our SQL Query Inspector middleware component. We will use the code that we have previously created in the last section of this course. However, we'll just add some additional and useful features to the application so that not only we can return the SQL queries, but let's capture, for example, if there are any duplicate queries that have been generated from the view. Because duplicate queries tells us that in actual fact, we need to look at the SQL code and potentially make some changes because we shouldn't necessarily have any duplicate queries. So the first step, we have already actually created our middleware in the previous tutorial. So let's just get rid of the before here. We're not going to need to do anything before the view. So everything here is going to happen after the view. So let's go back into our views here. We're going to strip out from the view the component we built, which was actually printing out the SQL code to the terminal. So let's go ahead and we're just going to remove that. We're going to place that into the middleware now. Okay. And then, of course, we're going to need to bring in all the resources related to it. So SQL parse, PyDemints, the connection, pretty much what we're going to need there, I think. So let's go back into the middleware. Let's just drop that in. Right, so with that in place, let's just go ahead and test this to see if it works. Open up the server's already on. So I'll just close that if you can't remember how to start doing that. Can't remember how to start the server. Sorry. So I'll close that. Let's run the server again. And let's go back into the browser. We'll just refresh. So now we have the middleware working. Let's just tidy up our view. That's pretty much all that's in the view now. We're just serializing the data from the query set and then returning it as a JSON response. So back in the middleware, this is the middleware at the moment. You can see that this is going to be initiated after the view. And we brought all the resources in that we're going to need. So let's think about some other features that we might need here. So as I mentioned, what would be really useful is if we could check to see if there were any duplicate queries. Now, if you're not familiar with Django and queries and such, this isn't necessarily going to make much sense, but it is an important feature because once you start scaling your database, once you've got multiple relationships, you're going to find that some queries that you run will produce multiple queries, which are the same or duplicates. And this is telling us that potentially we want to change the queries to make them more performant. And there are many tools in the Django ORM toolkit that we can use to do that. So let's get started making some change. So the first thing that we could do, for example, is we could check to see if settings is set to debug true. So we only want to run this if the settings has been set to debug set to true. Otherwise, we know that the application is in production mode. Maybe it has been actually implemented onto a server. So we go ahead and from the Django config, so from Django.conf. Let's import, import the settings. There we go. So we can access that. So that's the first thing we do. Let me just highlight that out for now. Right. So that's the first thing that we're going to do. We're going to check to see if Django is in debug mode. So we know that we are going to be in development mode. Right. So we can go ahead and count how many queries, for example, there is in the connection queries. log. So let's call this number of queries. So let's just grab that first. So number of queries equals, and then we're just going to grab the length of connection.queries. Remember, that's where we're grabbing and getting the information about queries that are run. So we're just going to determine how many queries there are, or how many queries that have been run. So that can be useful information, the total amount of queries. So we're going to output that. So let's build that out. So we're going to build a section for this. So let's create a new section. It starts off like that, and then we go for a print. So this is going to be a new line, of course. And then we call this SQL stats. So this is what's going to be outputted to the terminal. So then we create a new line, print. And then this is where we're going to print out, I think, yeah, the number of queries. So use F and here, number of queries. We'll print that out and then get the right. And then we'll say total queries. There we go. Right. So we'll print this at the end to make a nice little block. There we go. So let's give that a go. Now the server is turned on, so we just need to refresh the homepage. If you have forgotten why we keep refreshing this homepage, remember this is initiating our view and thus then initiating our middleware. So I'll just refresh that. Go back down here. We can now see in the terminal, we have SQL stats, one total queries. So now we know how to capture the total number of queries. Let's now think about iterating over the queries and outputting. So let's just take back our code here. We'll write this out again. So for query, that's going to be in the if statement. For query in connection.queries. So we're going to loop through all the connection queries, and then we're going to print out, like we've done here, we're going to print out everything. So let's just bring this back in, our code from before where we formatted and highlighted. So for each query in connection queries, let's go ahead and do that. So we're going to need to bring in query here, not query set, query. Okay. So same as before. So we're going to iterate through all the queries that have been generated. So you can see what's going to happen here is that we're going to have a printout whereby it's going to print out all the SQL statements. And then at the end, it's going to have this summary, if you like. So the server's turned on. Let's just check this out. So again, I'll just quickly refresh this page and we can take a look. So here we have the queries in place. They've been formatted. And then at the end, we're going to have this summary. Now, you might remember that inside of each of these queries, in addition to the actual query, there was some additional information, and that was the query time. So what we can do is we can iterate through all of these different queries and we can grab that time information, and then we can go ahead and calculate the total execution time for it. So let's go ahead and do that. So first of all, let's bring in, because we're going to be utilizing a decimal here. So let's go from decimal. Let's import a decimal. There we go. And in here, remember each time for each query, we want to grab the time information, and then we're going to add that to a variable that we're going to create here. So we can execution total execution time. How about that? Equals at the moment, so just decimal. So we set that up. And so we're going to keep adding to that variable each time we iterate over each query. So let's go ahead and take total execution time. And then we're going to plus equals a decimal. And then we're going to grab the query information. And then the specifically inside of that, the time information. So we're going to grab the time information inside of the query data that's been generated. And then we're just going to add that up into this query, into this variable here. Each time we add a new query that's just going to keep adding up. Right. So with that in place, I think we have got everything there. So let's go back into our summary and let's just print that out. So here we're going to print out total execution time. Okay. Right. So let's give this a go. Now, I can't imagine there's going to be too much here, but let's just go ahead and refresh this. I go back and we can now see that we do have some execution time registered here, 0.001. So you could go ahead and change the decimals and so on, but then we're going to keep it like that. That seems like it's okay for now. Right, so the last thing is we're going to check for duplicates. Right, so next up, we're going to check for duplicate queries. So what we're going to do here is we're going to create a new variable, check duplicates equals, and we're going to create a set. Now, with a Python set here, essentially we cannot store values that are the same inside of it. So if we pass in the query and we find that the query already exists in the set, then it's not going to be saved twice. So therefore, we know how many queries we start with, or how many total queries, and then we can calculate how many queries are in the set, thus then working out potentially how many duplicate queries we had. Now, we aren't going to necessarily be able to check it at this point, but let's go ahead and implement this. So check duplicates. We're going to total time. Let's do it right here. So we're going to check duplicates. We're going to add to our set. And that's going to be the query SQL. There we go. So every time we iterate over the queries, it's going to be passed into our set. And like I said, no two queries can be the same in the set. So that's only going to capture the unique queries. So then we can go ahead and we can then down here, we can print out how many duplicate queries we may have had. So F number of queries. Let's just grab the number of queries. So number of queries, and then we need to do a small calculation. So minus the length of the check duplicates. And then that should give the total. That should provide us then the total duplicates. Duplicates. And there we go. Right. So let's open up the homepage. Just do a refresh on there. Take a look in the terminal here. So we have our query, we have total queries, number of duplicates, and then we have this final execution time. Right. So now we have our middleware in place. We could, of course, just copy and paste this into every single Django project that we work with where we want to inspect the SQL queries. So now that we have our new middleware, of course, we could use this middleware on multiple projects because we could just copy and paste this file over to all of our projects. But maybe a more flexible way of working would be to create a package. So we're going to package this up into a Python package and then publish it onto the Python package index. By doing that, it means that we can download this like we do Django and other packages from the Python package index using pip. Therefore, at the start of any project, we can go ahead and pip install our package, which is this middleware, and then activate it through the settings.